That's what's on the bikes. The gold part is it's going to go around six times. It's what that is, the magnet pan. Uh-huh. It's like this, and then there's a sun gear in the middle of it that turns the planetary gears, and then we have a one-way bearing here in the middle of it so that if you're riding the bike or coasting, it freewheels. And then the motor's running, it catches up with that, and it drives the outer hub through the planetary gears. But that's how there's no drag on it.
But it's not regenerative braking.
It does not have regenerative braking. The reason we took it out of there was because of the drag that it would induce.
And
the amount of regenerative energy that you could get.
It wasn't worth it.
It's just not worth it. You can actually coast further than the amount of energy that you way further than the energy you could have gotten from regen. So it's just not worth it, especially on a bicycle, because if the battery goes dead on yours, the worst thing's going to happen to you here is you're riding a bicycle. If you were having to sit there and pull along a direct drive motor with it, it'd be like going up about a 4 or 5% hill all the time.
Yeah, at the house I've got extreme electric bike, 600, I think it's 600 watts or 600. Anyway, it's a battery bike. I've got a battery bike. It's got a flat at the moment. I got to fix the flat. But last year I used it to get to and from the grocery store. She would go about 15 miles an hour. Okay, not pedaling, but it was designed to be a pedal assist as compared to, a motorcycle per se. Now, are you guys pedal assist or?
It's either or any combination. You can pedal it, you can use the electric, ride it like a skinny motorcycle, or what I do is if you keep your speed down on it, you can go 10, 12 miles an hour and pedal along with it, and it's
going to make your range farther.
But it'll take off all by itself. You can ride it like a motorcycle.
Yeah. Well, I can do that with mine, but I top out 10, 15 miles an hour. So you're talking, what I call the pedal assist is what you're doing where you're both pedaling and using your human power and using your battery power.
Yeah, you can do that also, but by definition, I'm not calling you out on anything here, I'm just trying to explain it. Pedal assist means, or what we call pedal first, that it doesn't do anything unless you're pedaling.
Wait a minute, yes, so I do not have a pedal assist then. Yeah. So what I have is similar to what you've got here.
Not really per se.
One-way bearing on it. See what happened there? Mm-hmm. Okay. Because if the electrics aren't working for any reason, you'd cuss a blue streak trying to pedal this thing, or any direct drive motor, because it'd be like riding up a 4%, 5% grade all the time. Mm-hmm.
Drive and steer, set that up. Seats in your car, same thing. So the whole car is that way. It's all electronic now. It's a true 21st century car.
You put solar panels on your roof, and then you got it covered. Power your car.
That's because I'm not a tall guy.
Look over your shoulder here.
Oh, okay.
You got 204 miles you can go.
Yeah. That's apparently the distance remaining.
Yeah, that's the distance remaining.
204. I like it.
It's actually pretty hard to get less than 200. You got to work at it.
You got to work at it?
Yeah.
Don't worry, my husband.
And you can leave your camera on all the time. So that you can see your blind spots.
There's a rear view camera.
This guy right here. It looks strange because there's curtains instead of cars behind you.
How does it recharge? Do you have a special plug you need?
Basically, what most people do is they get the electrician to put in a 50 amp RV plug.
15 amp. Wow.
50.
50 amp.
Yeah, 50.
Oh, okay.
We're like a stove plug. It's just like adding a new stove.
Okay. All right.
It's pretty cheap and, doesn't require anything real special.
I guess that works.
Yeah.
Okay. It doesn't look very big.
I know. It doesn't look very big, but when you actually, you know, adjust the seat right,
your eyes are at the right level.
Yeah.
I understand.
Yeah. So that's Google Maps.
Okay. Yeah, that's what we used to get here.
You make that full screen. You got to pinch the zoom. But when you're driving, you use your turn-by-turn on the dash.
How nice. Look, an intelligent interface.
Yeah, how about that?
Wow, shocking. Shocked, I am shocked.
I know.
You are talking to a software engineer.
I'm a software engineer. I do GUI code. So it's nice to see an intelligent design and not a POS like a Ford system.
And you can set all kinds of things, like how you like your steering and how you like your brakes and all kinds of things like that.
And that explains part of the reason this thing is $70,000. That's an expensive car.
And then it's you've got driver profiles, and the driver profiles actually save a whole ton of stuff.
Wow, that's impressive.
You got your manual online.
Don't be under an EMP. This car would just stop.
And then there's your web browser.
How long did it take you to learn all this?
About the same time, you know.
A couple of weeks?
No, I don't even think that. It's just, you know, it's just like an iPhone, you know.
Okay.
I mean, you know, it's like.
Oh, I love it. Go back. What was that? Pacemaker?
Yeah. Oh, the.
Machine guns?
Yeah, well, you know.
Okay, that's worth a picture. That's just awesome. All right, I may have to buy me one of these.
Yeah, well, you know, somebody watched too many James Bond movies and had too much time on their hands.